Welcome back. In the previous class, what we have observed that one can easily find the solution of autonomous differential equation x dot equal to ax by using the idea of eigenvalue and eigenvectors. And one of the simplest case, what we found that if system matrix A has n distinct eigenvalue corresponding to n different eigenvector, then it is possible to give guarantee that all n eigenvector are linearly independent, and we can easily construct the full solution or closed form solution of x dot equal to ax. And after that, we have extended this result when system matrix A has complex eigenvalue, and corresponding to that, I have complex eigenvector. One of the most important case that is frequently occurring in case of any linear system, when system matrix A has equal roots. It means that if I have not n distinct eigenvalue, then in that case, basically how to write the closed form solution of x dot equal to ax. So main goal of the today's lecture, to construct the solution when we have equal eigenvalues. And after that, we will see that using the idea of eigenvalue, how basically we will formulate some new problem for the next class. So let us start the today's lecture. So I have already told you that if I have to solve x dot equal to ax, in that particular case, one of the most important quantity in this equation is a, and based on a, one can formulate the characteristic polynomial. And basically, meaning of characteristic polynomial is nothing but determinant a minus lambda I equal to 0. And based on this particular polynomial, I can first create the eigenvalue, and corresponding to that, I will create the eigenvector. And finally, what we will do that I will formulate the solution corresponding to each eigenvalue and eigenvector, and full solution is just the linear summation of all the solution, and this is due to the property of linearity. Now if consider the case when A doesn't have n distinct root, and in this case it is very difficult to give guarantee that I have n linearly independent vectors. So, and if I have not n linearly independent vectors, then I cannot able to talk about the full solution. So due to that reason, if I have n cross n system matrix of order n cross n, then I have to generate n linearly independent eigenvector, then only I can talk about the complete solution. So first I will give you the very simple example where I have just two independent eigenvectors. So I have considered this matrix, and this matrix is 3 cross 3 matrix, means each entry of this matrix is some real number. And if you calculate the characteristic polynomial, it is possible to show that I have lambda 1 equal to 1 and lambda 2 equal to 2. And these two are distinct eigenvalue, and another third eigenvalue is not distinct, that is coming from either 1 or 2. In this problem, that is again 1. And corresponding to one eigenvalue, we know that how to generate the eigenvector. Just I have to solve this kind of algebraic equation A and lambda I into V equal to 0. So I have to substitute value of lambda and correspondingly I have to generate the eigenvector. So we have generated two eigenvector corresponding to lambda 1 and lambda 2. So these two are the eigenvector. And after that, what we are telling that now in this particular problem, suppose that I have differential equation like x dot equal to ax, and where matrix A is given like this particular matrix, 3 cross 3 matrix, then we are just able to generate two eigenvector, and these two eigenvector, whatever I have generated, that looks like this and this. And using help of eigenvalue, I have written here e power lambda t and eigenvector here and lambda equal to 1. So I have generated one solution and I have generated two solution. But if you see the complete solution, since I have three different roots of the characteristic polynomial, so somehow I have to generate three independent eigenvector, and corresponding to that I have to generate three independent solution, and finally complete solution is just the summation of these all solutions. So now our problem is to find the third linearly independent solution. So somehow I have to find or I have to generate third linearly independent eigenvector. So that is my problem. So now I am going to again generalize this problem, because whatever I am claiming, that is just for 3 cross 3 matrix, but in realistic situation I have n cross n system matrix. And suppose that using that matrix, if I have k that is less than n linearly independent eigenvector, so using help of k I have to find rest one, that is n minus k eigenvector. And if somehow we will achieve this, then I can tell that I can generate the complete solution of x dot equal to ax if a doesn't have distinct real root. So let us try to see that, means how basically solution one can obtain. So basically you can see here, suppose in autonomous case x dot equal to ax, if I have k linearly independent solution out of n, then I can basically generate that k linearly independent solution with help of this e power lambda t and v. So now just I have to find additional solution, that is n minus k. And if that is also linearly independent, then I can tell that complete solution is the just the summation of these all solution due to additivity property. Now let us try to see that how basically one can generate the additional solution with help of the k independent eigenvector or eigenvalue. So using that, how to generate additional eigenvalue and eigenvector. So I know that I have some repeated eigenvalue, so I know the eigenvalue, but I have to generate independent eigenvector. So that is my problem. So this is the formulation of problem. So let us see the approach. So approach is again same like the previous one. So what we have observed, that in case of the distinct eigenvalue, first we have started with the scalar case, and in case of a scalar, what we are claiming that if I have some kind of autonomous system of this form x dot equal to ax, where x belongs to R, then this xt equal to e power at into c, where c is some constant. So for all constant, xt equal to e power at into c is the solution of autonomous equation x dot equal to ax, provided x belongs to R. Now we are telling that, in similar way, I can claim that I have solution of this form xt equal to e power at, and now basically I am talking about the vector case. So I have n dimensional autonomous system. So at this time, that constant c, now I am going to replace that constant c by some constant vector v, and here in place of a, again I have same system matrix. So we are telling that xt equal to e power at into v, and where v is the some constant matrix. So if I select any constant matrix, that will satisfy this solution x dot equal to ax, because at this particular moment I haven't given any kind of initial condition. So due to that reason, I am claiming that for all v, xt equal to e power at into v is a solution of x dot equal to ax. So if a is the scalar quantity, then I know that how to do the expansion, and expansion of this, so this is somehow infinite expansion, and if a is constant, then we know that I can write I plus at plus a square t. Similarly, if you replace a by some matrix, a square matrix a, I can still able to write like this, and it is possible to show that for all t, this series, particular infinite series, is going to converge to e power at. So this result is already well known in the literature. So using the help of this particular series, I am going to take the differentiation on the both hand side. So you can see that after taking differentiation, I am going to generate a e power a into t. So one can easily observe from here that I have particularly this kind of relation. So if you take the differentiation of this e power at into v, where v is the constant vector, then again I can able to get this kind of quantity, means a multiplied by same constant vector. And if you replace this particular box quantity by xt, so you can see that now I have dx by dt equal to ax. So we are telling that due to this reason, I am telling that if I have dx by dt equal to ax, and if I substitute x equal to a power at into v, so for all constant v, I have solution. So this for all constant v, this particular quantity is going to satisfy this particular equation, and due to that reason, I can express solution in form of a power t. So even if a has some repeated eigenvalue, that doesn't matter. But now somehow I have to construct something more, because using this information, I cannot claim anything. So now what we are telling, that how to find n linearly independent vector v for which the infinite series e power at into v can summed exactly, then only I can tell that finally I am able to find the closed form solution. So due to that reason, I am going to analyze e power at into v. So you can see here that e power at, I can easily further write like this. So what I have done, I am going to add one extra term, and I am going to subtract one extra term. And it is not difficult to show that A minus lambda t, lambda I multiplied by lambda I, where I is identity matrix, so that will satisfy commutative VT property. So AB equal to B into A. So you can easily check it. Now I can also further able to write this particular series e power lambda I t into V like this form. So you can see that here simply if I t in and after that I am going to absorb in this side, because if I have I square, then again that is I identity matrix. So square of any power of identity matrix is itself identity matrix. So if I will collect that identity matrix with V and multiplication of identity matrix with V, so I can again generate same kind of terms. So what it means that even if here I identity matrix will present or not present, that doesn't matter for us. And due to that reason, again, this whatever things I have subtracted or added, so finally I am going to get this kind of, so I am going to get this particular form of expression. And basically this expression, based on this expression, now it is possible to derive the further result. So I am going to talk about that. So finally I will get this kind of expression e power a t v. I can write here e power lambda t e power a minus lambda t lambda I into t into v. Now let us try to see some more observation. So suppose that I have some eigenvector v, and if that will satisfy this kind of condition, then it is possible to show that this series e power a lambda I t into v terminates after m. And it is not difficult, because what happens that if you will expand it, then after m term you are easily able to get this kind of term. And if this term is zero, and it is possible to show that if this term is zero, then higher power of this m plus l, so for all l again that is zero. So if that is zero for all l, then what happens that this series, since a lambda I power m v equal to zero, if somehow I am able to prove and all other quantities below that, means m minus 1 is not zero, then it is possible to show that this series, infinite series, is now terminated into some kind of finite series. So from infinite quantity it is possible to extract the finite one. And so based on that, now I am going to generate one kind of algorithm, such that if I have one eigenvector v, using that how one can construct the another independent eigenvector. And here you can see that I am assuming a lambda I power m into v equal to zero. So this whole quantity e power a t into v, that is represented by this finite series. And it is possible to show that this finite series has some kind of finite summation. So now based on this, I am going to generate the closed form solution of x dot equal to ax. So let us try to see. So here you can first try to observe this thing, that suppose if I have an distinct eigenvalue at that time, you can see that from here a minus lambda I into v. And in order to generate v, what we are doing, we are just solving a minus lambda I into v equal to zero. So if I have n distinct eigenvector, then this equal to zero, so all higher quantity equal to zero. So due to that reason, we are telling that the solution of this form e power lambda t into v. So corresponding to each eigenvalue, I have eigenvector, and if in this way I can generate n number of eigenvector, and based on that I can construct the solution and I can find the complete solution. So first case is the classical one. If I am assuming that and I have A has n linearly independent eigenvector. So if n has n linearly independent eigenvector, then I have already told you that all higher order term t a minus lambda I into v and higher than that, that is equal to 0. So basically whole series is terminated here only. So this case is the simplest one. We have already seen this case. So I have just, because whenever you are deriving some kind of generalized case, then if you substitute the special condition, then that should be recover that special solution. Due to that reason, this is means in this way you can check that whatever algorithm you are going to propose, that is true or not true. Now suppose the second case, if A has only k minus k less than n linearly independent eigenvector, then we have only k linearly independent solution, and in that form k linearly independent solution of this form, and in order to generate the additional solution, I have already told you that if you want to find some kind of second solution, so we know the complete solution of this form. So this is the complete solution. So somehow, in order to generate the second independent solution, I have to further truncate this particular series. And how to do that? I have to construct some kind of V which will satisfy this kind of condition. So what we will do, we will pick each and every eigenvector or repeated eigenvector, and after that I will try to find this a minus lambda I square v equal to 0, but this is not equal to 0, and in this way I am able to generate the second linearly independent solution. So I have already k linearly independent solution. So if a minus lambda square v equal to 0, but a minus lambda I v not equal to 0, then now I am able to generate k plus 1 solution. After that, again, you can do the same process. Now try to substitute a minus lambda I cube into v equal to 0, and at that time, we make sure that a minus lambda I square v not equal to 0. And in this way, you are able to recover the second independent solution. So what we are telling that if I have not enough solution, why I am telling enough solution? Suppose A is 3 cross 3 matrix and already you have found two solutions, then you have to just generate one solution. But if that is 4 cross 4 matrix and you have two independent solution, then you have to generate two more solution. So again, you have to proceed for further step, and at that time, just you have to make sure that this particular quantity a minus lambda I square v not equal to 0, but you have to select v in such a way such that this equal to 0, and in this way I can generate the third solution or third additional solution, and I will proceed this till we will able to generate n linearly independent solution, and in this way final solution is just linear combination of all solution. So things is very very easy. What you can do, first you can calculate the eigenvalue and try to see that which eigenvalue is basically repeating. After that, what you can do, you can calculate a minus lambda I and power 2 into v and try to see those kind of v which will make this particular multiplication equal to 0, and after that, at the same time, you can verify that A minus lambda I into V, that is not equal to 0. In this way, you can generate second solution. Similarly, A square is non-zero. A lambda I square V is non-zero, but A lambda I cube into V equal to 0. Then in that way, you can generate the third solution by putting everything inside that series. And in this way, I can generate the whole solution. And final solution is just the linear combination, because now I am giving guarantee that whatever solution I am going to generate, all are linearly independent. So basically, complete solution is just nothing but the linear combination of all linearly independent solutions. So let us try to see how to use this to solve one problem. So I have selected very simple problem. And what I am telling that, suppose I have some kind of autonomous system like this, where this matrix is, I have defined A. So again, first step I have to perform, that I have to find the characteristic polynomial. So this is the characteristic polynomial, and root of this characteristic polynomial is nothing but the eigenvalue. And here you can see that I have two linearly independent eigenvalue. So correspondingly, I can generate two independent eigenvector. But here one is repeating, so due to that reason, I cannot generate third one. So again, I have to take help of the above method, whatever I have discussed the algorithm. And this is very standard result that is in linear algebra. So everything is brought from linear algebra only. So try to find the two solution from the eigenvalue lambda equal to 1, and procedure is very simple. So I have already told you that I have to find non-zero vector such that this equal to 0, and if you will see here, then v2 and v3 equal to 0, but v1 I can take any arbitrary value, and due to that reason I have expressed my first solution or linearly independent solution corresponding to eigenvalue 1, that is expressed like this. Now I have to find the second solution, and how to do that? Again, A minus lambda I square into V, and after that, if you do this manipulation, then finally it is possible to show that V3 equal to 0, and both V1 and V2 are, one can select arbitrary. So if you select V1 and V2 arbitrarily, so I have selected V3 equal to 0 and V2 equal to 1, and after that I have to check this condition. I have told you that this condition is very important, otherwise again I will end up to the dependent solution, and due to that reason I have to make sure that A minus I into V, that should be not equal to 0, and in this way I can construct the second solution by just putting inside the truncated series, and I have generated the second solution. And third solution, using the eigenvalue lambda equal to 2, I can again do same kind of process, and I can generate the third solution. So complete solution is just the summation of this solution. So you can also write like this, xt is, now I have c1 x1t first solution, c2 x2t second solution, and plus 3 c3 x3t. And if you have initial condition, information of initial condition, then it is possible to recover the value of c1, c2 and c3. And here I am going to state one of the most beautiful result, and this result basically we are going to use in our next part of this course, and due to that reason I am going to state this result here. For time being, I am not going to discuss the proof, but this is home assignment for all of you, that please try to look the proof from any standard book or on internet. This is easily available, so you have to understand the proof by yourself, because proof is very much straightforward, and after that you have to basically recall that proof. So basically what I am telling, that suppose I have some kind of characteristic polynomial like this, and if p lambda, you can see that using characteristic polynomial, equating that characteristic polynomial, I can also able to calculate the all eigenvalue. So if that is the characteristic polynomial, it is possible to show that this characteristic polynomial, if you substitute matrix A matrix here, so lambda is some kind of a scalar here, but if you substitute the matrix A, so basically this polynomial is generated from this particular matrix. But if you put this matrix here, then it is possible to show that this is equal to 0. So this is one of the very much important result. Now let us try to see the some more use of the eigenvalue and eigenvector also. So basically in this part of lecture, just I am going to give the hint, and next class I will discuss the more depth inside this observation. So what we are telling, that suppose I have some kind of general linear system. So general linear system can be represented like this, autonomous system obviously this is. So here you can see that I have a11, a12, a21 and a22. So what happens that if I have simple scalar system, something like x dot equal to ax, and I have already told you that it has very very simple geometrical meaning that x belongs to R, and based on that I am able to see that using this parameter, either I am going to converge towards the x equal to 0 or I am going to diverge towards the x equal to 0. But here you can see that due to this coupling, I cannot able to talk anything very easily. And why I am not able to talk, then physical interpretation is like this, because now I am in two-dimensional plane. And if you are in two-dimensional plane, so suppose if you are here, then I can move in this direction, so I have infinite many choice I can move. But suppose that if you are on two-dimensional or only one dimension, then you have just three choices, either you can move in this direction, or you are going to remain here. So I have limited choice, but here I have unlimited choice. So it is very difficult to talk about behavior if I have this kind of situation. So now another motivation, that is it possible to convert this kind of second order coupled system into some kind of two different decoupled system, then again I can apply the first order kind of analysis. So and after that I can talk about the qualitative behavior. Qualitative behavior means there is no need to know the exact solution, because without knowing the exact solution also I can talk about the behavior of x dot equal to ax. And you also know that by knowing solution one can always talk. So so using this solution I can tell that if a is positive and t is tending towards infinity, then I can diverge to the infinity. But if you do not know the exact solution, again I can talk about the response and just by seeing this geometrical picture. So and this analysis is also called phase plane analysis. I will tell you that why people are telling phase plane analysis in the next lecture. So I have taken generalized system. Now our goal, I hope that you have understood the goal, that I have some connected second order system, so somehow I have to make some kind of decoupling. Decoupling is not always possible, but in some case complete decoupling is possible, some case one can do the partial decoupling. So I will tell you that what is three different case which is related to the eigenvalue. So I have defined one kind of transformation, and this transformation I am telling that I have z equal to m into x. Here m is 2 cross 2, and I am at the same time I am also assuming that this m matrix is non-singular, and you are able to understand that why I am telling that this is non-singular, because you can see that if I apply the transformation, so somehow I have two different domain. I am here an x coordinate, and I am going to move to z coordinate with help of this matrix m. Now after doing the analysis, again I have to back to original coordinate frame, and how to back from z to a, again I need the inverse transformation. And when inverse of some matrix will come into picture. If this matrix, I am assuming that matrix M is invertible and all entry of this matrix is some kind of constant real quantity. So that is 2x2 matrix, each entry is constant real quantity and that is invertible, then I can able to express this system Z dot equal like this, M inverse ZT. Now question is that how to find this transformation, and one of the easiest way to find this transformation by looking the eigen value. And here you can see that since X and Z has some relation, so initial condition is also going to transform using this kind of relation Z0 equal to MX0. It is possible to show that if you know the eigen value, and now I am not going to talk about the eigen value because you all know. So if I know the eigen value of A, here A matrix is the system matrix, and if I know the eigen value of A, so since it is 2x2 matrix, so again I have three different choices. So it might possible I have two different distinct eigen value and that is real, sometime I have repeated eigen value. So if I have distinct, then I can give guarantee that this transformation MAM inverse can be written like this. So you can calculate the eigen value, you can put the eigen value and A matrix you are knowing, so it is possible to construct this transformation M. So using help of eigen value, I can construct the transformation M such that it is possible to show. You can see that now here that whatever our system, so I am telling that Z dot equal to MAM inverse, and if you apply MAM inverse here, then I can further able to write. So I am going to write, then things become more clear to you. So what basically I am telling here that I have, after substituting this particular quantity MAM inverse here, I have Z1 dot equal to lambda1 Z1 and Z2 dot equal to lambda2 Z2. So you can see that these two systems are fully decoupled, means Z1 is no longer going to depends on the Z2. So basically if I analyze this equation separately and this equation separately, still I can talk about the whole solution of X by applying this kind of transformation. So somehow geometrically I am converting two dimensional system into two decoupled one dimensional system, and here coordinate is Z1 and Z2. And more commonly, that means initially I am on this axis, now I am transforming to another axis like this. So here initially based on initial condition I was somewhere here, and after doing transformation somehow I am going to limit myself on these two line only, and this line is nothing but Z2 and Z1. Here this is X1 and X2. So I can apply geometrical analysis, and this form is called diagonal form. And you know that why I am telling this form as a diagonal form, because now I have whole 2x2 matrix that is converted into some kind of diagonal matrix. And it is possible to show that even if that is not distinct, then also sometime we are getting this form. But sometime we are getting this kind of form also if I have repeated eigen value, and this form is called Jordan form. So Jordan form, diagonal form, I have only diagonal entry, but in Jordan form I have some kind of additional entry also. So this system is partially decoupled system, because you can see that Z2 axis is now become independent. So independently you can solve Z2, and after that you can substitute here in Z1. And another possibility is related to complex. So if you have complex eigen value, then it is possible to show that this transformation I can write like this, and again I have some extra advantage if I will write like this. So in next class, what I am going to do, I am going to take help of these three classes and going to talk about not the complete solution but the approximate solution, how basically solution will looks in two dimensional plane. And due to that reason, phase plane analysis is limited to two dimension, because you can easily visualize, but it is possible to extend for three dimension also. In that case, you have to talk about x, y, y, z, z, x, like that. But most of time, if you see any classical book or any standard book, people are just talking about two dimension, because two dimension things I can easily visualize. So now it is time to conclude this lecture. So what we have observed in this lecture, that suppose I have autonomous system, and if I have repeated route or repeated route of the characteristic equation, at that time I have less number of the independent eigenvector, and due to that reason I cannot able to find the complete solution. Due to that reason, somehow I have to construct the independent eigenvector. So we have proposed some kind of algorithm. Using that algorithm, I can construct the remaining solution, and after that I found the complete solution. And second part, what we have seen, that if I have some two dimensional autonomous system, generalized autonomous system, using help of eigenvalue, I can express that system in some simple form. And if eigenvalue is distinct, then what happens, that in different coordinate system, my system is fully decoupled. If eigenvalue is repeated, then it is partially decoupled. And in complex case, I have another form that I am going to discuss in the next class. So with these observations, now I am going to stop today's lecture. So thank you very much.